In my humble opinion, GarageBand is one of the most underrated programs. The simplicity, I love the ease of use. It is very easy to use with an iPad. I use it all the time with my iPad to make backtracks. On this particular video, I'm going to show you how to use it to make backtrack loops on your MacBook Pro or any Apple computer. Once you've opened up GarageBand, you click here to open up your sound library and it gets you this screen. And after you have a track, you're going to go to Window, Show Musical Typing, and from there you'll get the keyboard synthesizer. And here you can just play the notes from your keyboard and it will come out like you're playing an instrument. In this case, I'm trying to choose some synthesizer sounds, and I'm going to try out a couple different ones to find the one that I want. Creating your own loops, you can see that GarageBand offers quite a few different sounds that you can use. And like I said before, I have gotten tagged using their pre-recorded loops, so I try to stay away from those. So you can see, and even you go into each one and there's quite a few, and some of them are real bizarre. Some of them will loop around. I just go ahead and try to put them together. If you remember the major scale, you're in good shape. And that usually means when you're doing your keys, you'll skip one between the B and C and the E and F. There's a half step, if you know a little bit of theory. If you don't, just go ahead and do it till it sounds right. So you can see, some of these have quite a few more, some of them don't. And if you see these arrows, that means they have quite a few more. And some of these will go on for a while. Some of them are very bizarre, but some of them are really nice. And you've got your GarageBand keys, and you know, when you hit them, you'll get a sound depending on what you've chosen. The synthesizer one usually gives you the easiest to make the loops because they're so diverse, and the one note will loop around. Who can copyright a note? I guess we'll find out. Using your keyboard is hard to get the timing right on these, especially if you have a funky sound like we are doing with this, but it's really easy to go back into the editor and reposition the notes. The sequencer has always given me really funky results, so I just prefer to do it by hand. You can also edit this in sheet music mode, but I'm not as good with the notes as I am with these bars. I've just gotten used to the bars. And sometimes you'll get an odd sounding one, usually from rolling your finger or hitting it not just right. Sometimes moving it'll fix it, sometimes it won't. So sometimes you have to copy and paste. And I like to just get one good measure down or two good measures down and then just copy and paste it through the whole 1 minute loop. And you can use the looper up top. It'll loop it around and let you know if you've got the right stop and start points. Got the first track the way I want it, and now I'll go on to do the second track. Now, if you don't get these perfect, don't worry about it. I like to move the sound bars around, and you can edit it any way you want. Even if I hit the wrong note, I could move it back to where I wanted it. But to me, this is a very easy way to edit digital music. That's an example of my finger not hitting the key directly on the top, and it gives you that sound. Sometimes you can move that note and it'll fix it. Sometimes you have to take that note out. And what I will usually do, I'll find a good measure and just take out all the notes and then go to the good measure, copy the notes, and then paste them in. And that's the easy way to do it. When you finish your loop, you're going to want to share it to iTunes. You'll go to Share and Song to iTunes. Once you get it in iTunes, you can grab the file and put it anywhere that you'd like to. The box comes for you to put your information in it. I put a title, I put my name as the artist, composer. I have all of my songs in different files and playlists. So I'll do this in iTunes, and then I'll also take the file and copy it into a folder so that way I've got two copies of this. And I always save it the best quality possible. And it'll take a couple seconds depending on the length of your song.